Hello and welcome to The Banker's Fresh Perspectives video. I'm Joy Macknight, editor of The Banker, and with me in the studio is Nina Kerkez, an expert specializing in anti-money laundering at LexisNexis Risk Solutions, to discuss their recent report on the cost of financial crime compliance in the UK. Thanks so much for joining me, Nina.
Thank you for having me.
So what are the drivers for rising costs in financial crime compliance, such as anti-money laundering and customer due diligence in the UK?
So we do this report every couple of years, and obviously we continue to see the increases in costs, specifically when it comes to being compliant. So we are working with financial institutions primarily to look at how those costs increase. So over the last couple of years, the costs have increased further, and today the spend for compliance amongst financial institutions in the UK is estimated to be at £34.2 billion, right? So huge, huge number. And typically, if we look at it, so what are those drivers? We have the external and the internal factors that are impacting the costs, the cost increase. So if we think of some of the external factors, it continues to be, the increase in regulation. That really kind of stands out as we talk to some of our clients and the market. Although over the last couple of years, we haven't seen any new regulation in the UK, they're still struggling to kind of keep up with what has happened previously. A lot of the organizations have received those kind of dear CEO letters, and so they feel that regulatory pressure above them continuously. So that's kind of the main external driver. If we look at the internal drivers, we then see things such as increased customer due diligence. So they have to understand their customers better. You know, they're just dealing with a wider network of entities, they're onboarding people. Kind of some second driver is investigations. So once they've onboarded a person, it's actually understanding who they are and looking deeper into them and their network. And last but not the least, there is a technology element. So there has been an increase in spend when it comes to technology. Primary driver is that customer due diligence, and we've seen the number spike from, I think it was 52% of, a couple of years ago, to roughly 65% where it is today.
That's so interesting. So what other trends did your research surface?
Plenty of information in the research, but some of the other typical trends are typically training of employees. What really came out strongly is that training of employees in compliance is costing almost three times the technology spent in compliance. So quite a bit of disparity there that tells us a lot on how the financial institutions are recruiting people, onboarding people, and truly trying to ensure that that kind of culture of compliance, penetrates every area of their business. The technology spend has, of course, gone up. So we see a lot of drivers towards automation, some drivers when it comes to orchestration. However, the organizations are saying that they're still not seeing that kind of efficiency gain from technology. So that's really interesting to observe. I think we need to be mindful that, it does take time for us to get there, and, they will get there, but it's not just kind of flip the switch and the technology does the magic for you, because it's not quite there. There has been an increase in some of the manual tasks still performed. So technology can indeed, help facilitate some of the onboarding and reviews of customers. But at the end of the day, we do need people to do some of the more difficult tasks, to truly understand the customers, to do the investigations. So again, that is another factor that has impacted the growth of costs.
So obviously one of the big things that happened in the past year is the Ukraine and Russia conflict. How did that impact the costs in terms of financial crime compliance?
Surprisingly or not, it didn't really impact the change in cost. Our clients and the people that participated in the survey have said that there's roughly been 3% increase in costs that's related to geopolitical changes. Really, what that means is that a lot of the people in the market already understand the repercussions when it comes to sanctions, right? So that's really kind of what's happened over the last year, is that we've seen a spike in the numbers of entities or individuals that have been sanctioned. These are targeted sanctions. And if you are already utilizing tools that are helping you uncover any sanctions, this should already be covered. So the change there might be that, you know, their investigations have gone up slightly, but actually nothing too impactful for them when it comes to cost-related issues.
So what are your predictions when it comes to financial crime compliance costs in the future?
You know, it's always difficult to predict and look in the future. But I forgot to mention earlier that actually AML and fraud are still sort of being kept separate in you know, kind of two functions. What we are starting to see slowly is the convergence of the two and, you know, the term FRAML now being used, so fraud and AML, anti-money laundering. And so I really predict that that will continue to be a trend. And I think that, you know, both are economic crimes. You can't have one without the other. They can't quite function. You know, the two teams can't quite function without each other. And it's very important that they collaborate. So that is certainly one of the trends that I foresee. I see an increase in the use of technology. So again, more push towards automation. The industry has been talking about AI, machine learning for years. You know, that's all well and good, but we have to have good data to help us actually build on top of that. And perhaps we can see some use of those technologies, such as robotic process automation, specifically when it comes to investigations. Although the industry that we're working in is still requiring, as I said, those kind of, you know, manual investigations to be handled by individuals. So I don't foresee that changing. And lastly, I think we will start to see financial institutions think about the value that they can gain from compliance functions. So we don't want to focus just on them being cost centers. It's also what else can, you know, the information, the data that I gather, the information that I hold on my customers tell me about the customer so that I can offer them better products.
So my last question is, what activities can banks or financial institutions do in order to, on the one hand, improve financial crime compliance effectiveness, but then also then reduce the cost of compliance?
As I said, we've seen the trends towards automation, the trends towards orchestration, and I think that will definitely help them in the future as they continue to invest in compliance. We also know that they're trying to educate all of the teams across the business about what compliance means and what compliance actually is, and they're getting quite a lot of that kind of tone from the top. So forget about the compliance teams, which already know what they're doing. It's actually does everybody else in the business know what the impact of compliance is. And when we think about it, what I you know, really foresee changing is the message that they get from the management. So it's not about you know, regulators coming after us or us getting fined. It's actually about how can we prevent the wrongdoings in the market. So how can we prevent human trafficking, drug smuggling, arms proliferation, fraud, scams, all the rest of that. And so that's what we are doing. We're not here to just review the data of our customers. And so I think that message might change. We also know that the NCA over the last year has had a significant increase in STRs, so the reports that they receive from the market, the suspicious activity reports. And so there's definitely more activity, but perhaps collaboration with that public sector, better collaboration with the public sector might work better for them. So continuing to build on those public to private partnerships is certainly something that we expect to see in bettering the culture of compliance.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for your insights, Nina. And thanks to the audience for watching.